Git is a version control system widely used in software development. But is it the right choice for your data science project? Absolutely. Imagine this. You replace a current data processing technique with a new approach. After realizing that the new approach is not producing the desired results, you want to revert back to the previous working version. Unfortunately, without version control, it becomes a daunting task to undo multiple changes. With Git, you can track changes to your code base, compare changes, and roll back to a stable state if necessary. In another scenario, you collaborate with other data scientists on a machine learning project. To merge all changes made by team members, you need to manually exchange files and review each other's code, which takes time and effort. Git makes it easy to merge changes and synchronize progress, allowing you and your team members to work more efficiently together. Additionally, you may want to explore new approaches to enhance your model's performance, but are hesitant to make changes directly to the production code. Any unintended impact on the deployed model could have significant consequences for your company. With Git branching, you can create separate branches for different features. This allows you to test and iterate without compromising the stability of the production branch. Lastly, imagine a scenario where a hardware failure or theft results in the loss of all your code, setting you back months of work. Git backs up your projects by securely storing them on remote repositories. Thus, even if you encounter such unfortunate events, you can restore your code base from the remote repository and continue your work without losing significant progress. Now that we understand the value of Git, let's explore how we can effectively use it in different scenarios. Imagine this. You have a folder containing code in your local machine. How do you turn this folder into a Git repository? Start with running Git init to initialize Git in your current project. To use GitHub as a remote repository, create a new repository on GitHub and copy its URL. Then run git remote at origin repository URL to add the URL to your local git repository with the name origin. Next, run git add to stage changes in your git repository. Run git status to review the list of changes to be committed. Run git commit along with a commit message to save the stage changes permanently in the repository's history. Once your commits are made, you can share your changes with others by pushing them to a remote repository. After running this command, the main branch on the remote repository will receive the latest changes. In a collaboration scenario, how can you and your teammates contribute to an existing project simultaneously while avoiding conflicts? Start by running git clone repository URL to create the local copy of the remote Git repository on your local machine. This command will create a new repository with the same name as the remote repository. To access the files, navigate to the repository directory. To avoid any impact on the main code base, we will run git checkout-b fit1 to create and switch to a new branch named fit1 and then make changes on that branch. Next, add, commit, and push the changes to the new branch on the remote Git repository. After pushing the commit, you can create a pull request to merge the changes into the main branch. After your colleague approves and merges your pull request, your code will be integrated into the main branch. Imagine that you have created a branch called fit2 from the main branch. After making several changes to the fit2 branch, you discovered that the main branch has been updated. How do you merge the remote changes from the main branch into the local branch? First, make sure your local work is saved by staging and committing local changes. This prevents the remote changes from overriding your work. Next, use git pull origin main to pull the changes from the main branch on the remote repository. When executing this command for the first time, you will be prompted to choose a strategy for reconciling the branches. Running git config pull rebase false, we create a new merge commit in the fit2 branch that ties together the histories of the main branch and the fit2 branch. Running git config pull rebase true, we perform a rebase operation, which places the commits from the fit2 branch on top of the main branch. Rebase does not create new merge commits. Instead, it modifies the existing commits of the fit2 branch. This results in a cleaner commit history. However, the rebase command should be done with caution, particularly when other team members are actively using the same branch, such as the fit2 branch. If you rebase your fit2 branch while others are working on it, it can lead to inconsistencies in the branch history. Git may face difficulties when attempting to synchronize these divergent branches. If you're new to Git and prioritize simplicity over maintaining a clean history, use the merge approach as a default option, as it is easier to use compared to rebase. Imagine this. After creating new commits, you realize that the errors have been made within them and want to revert back to a specific commit. How do you do that? Start with running git log to identify the hash of the specific commit you want to revert to. Let's assume you want to revert back to commit 1. You can either use git revert or use git reset. Git revert commit hash creates a new commit that undoes the changes made after a specified commit. Git reset commit hash modifies the commit history by changing the branch pointer to the specified commit. While git reset keeps the commit history clean, it is more destructive since it discards commits. Git revert is a safer option as it leaves the original commits intact. When using Git for your data science project, it's essential to adhere to the following best practices. The first one is to have small commits. Having small commits ensures that each commit has a clear purpose, making it easier to understand revert changes and minimize chances of conflicts. Additionally, you should opt for descriptive branch names that accurately reflect the task or feature you're working on. Avoid vague names like @file or personal identifiers like John Branch. It is also important to keep consistent code formatting so that reviewers can focus on the logic of the code. In the following code, it is challenging for reviewers to pinpoint the addition of the print statement due to irregular indentation, spacing, and quotation marks. When the code is standardized, it becomes easier for reviewers to identify the addition of the print statement. To automatically check and reformat your code prior to committing it, use pre-commit. Here's an example of using git commit along with pre-commit. It executes the rough linter to check the code and executes black to reformat it, thereby enforcing code standards. In a data science project, there are certain files you should ignore, such as datasets and secrets, for the following reasons. Versioning binary datasets can significantly increase the repository size. Including secrets, such as credentials or API keys in the codebase, can pose a security risk if the repository is publicly shared. To exclude specific files or directories, you can add them to the gitignore file, located in the root directory of your project. A list of useful gitignore templates is linked in the description of this video. Even though Git is not ideal for versioning binary datasets, you can use data version control to store your original data in a separate location while keeping track of different versions of the data in Git. In this next video, you will learn how to use DVC to do exactly that.